Are huge Kenny G fans.
Yeah.
Huge Kenny G fans. So we thought it only made sense for them to have a Kenny G song for their first dance. So let's give them a nice, warm round of applause as we start their first dance. Thank you. and gentlemen, once again, let me give a nice warm round of applause. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be handing the microphone over to Karen, who is a longtime friend and the maid of honor for the evening. Let's give her a nice... Yes, you are. It's not me. Let's give her a nice, warm round of applause. She will be doing the toast this evening.
Okay.
I wanted to propose a toast to the bride and groom.
Yes.
But first, I wanted to tell you how I met them. And if you'll bear with me, I'll read my notes.
I'm too nervous to do it without.
Karen, Pete is outside.
Oh, well, let's wait. Peter, listen to me!
Yeah, tell him.
Bad Pete! Peter, Andrew, Frank, we've been waiting for you. Oh, please take your seat. Please take your seat. I'm giving a speech.
It gets worse, Karen. It's Peter, Andrew, Franklin, Frank.
Peter, Andrew, Franklin, Frank. Please take your seat. I'm giving a speech.
Helen wants more alcohol.
Can someone please bring Helen more alcohol? You okay, Mom? I met Susan when we were both 6 years old.
Oh my God.
That's almost 40 years ago. That was in the summer. In the summer between kindergarten and grade one. Now, when her family moved to Crawford Park, Parkdale Avenue, I went over to their house to meet the new girl who had just moved in. And on our first meeting, we were just a little bit shy with each other. And we talked, and we discovered that we were both the youngest in our families, and we both had brothers, no sisters. We would both be in the same class together in school for many years to come.
Same grade.
Yeah. Same grade, for same class. And we both had blue ice skates. We were the only two girls we knew who had blue ice skates. It was a match made in heaven. As we grew up together, what, Sue?
They must have been on sale.
I'll ask them. How come you bought me? Never. As we grew up together, we spent almost every day together. We shared our hopes and dreams, and later our sorrows and our joys. And we learned what sisterhood was all about.
And Paul McCartney's picture.
I thought it best not to talk about that. Now, we all know that Susan is made up of the very best of qualities. It's hard to find someone who is truly as caring and giving and generous. She's someone who can reach out to so many people and remain fiercely loyal to all of them. If you're fortunate enough to have her friendship, you know you can count on it always. But it wasn't until she met Sam Mary. That she found someone deserving enough to spend her life with. And they complement each other in many ways. Susan is very social. Sam is the philosopher. Sam is spiritual, and Susan is more grounded. Susan is the doer. Sam is the fixer.
Sure is. They gotta get the house.
Susan is the romantic. Sam is very practical. Susan's spontaneous. Sam loves stability. Susan's funny. I'm a little bit quirky. And Sam is very tolerant. A match made in heaven. That's the second match made in heaven. Sam is wise, and he's strong, and he's true. They are devoted to each other and to their family. At a party a few years ago, Sam was watching Susan as she actually danced from one room to another, making sure everybody was taken care of and having a good time. And he smiled as he watched her and he said, "I can't believe I get to spend the rest of my life with this beautiful soul."
No.
I hadn't said
yes yet.
And she hadn't even said yes yet.
Who was he talking about?
Gee, that's giving me a hard time. Now, where am I, Dominic? You messed up my cards. I'm so glad you found each other, Sam. No, I missed something. Oh, no, Dominic.
What
is he about
to watch?
Drop that thing up.
Okay, I'm good. I'm good. And I'm almost done.
No, Karen, we're loving it. We're loving it.
Could you repeat this later?
I'll send you a call. Sam, I am so glad that you found each other. I know you will always love and protect my sister. Let's raise a glass in a toast.
Here, here.
Knock on wood.
To Mr. Wright and Mrs. Always Wright. Susan and Sam.
How much have you had to drink?
Just enough to do that.
Yeah.
might just get, you might fall trying to do what I did. Mama, come, mama, come, mama, come, son.
I'm faking it.